subscribe to Bizbo and press the bell icon. See boring news turn into enjoyable stories. On World Wrestling Day, 38-year-old Sushil Kumar should have been inaugurating an akhada or something. Instead, he was busy hiding from the Delhi police with his buddy Ajay Bakkarwala.
Kitna paisa bacha hai Ajay?
Bhai, zyada nahi, kuch karna padega.
For over 2 weeks now, the duo had been evading cops in a cat and mouse chase across states. The story starts on the night of May 4th, when Sushil allegedly drove to Model Town to visit Sagar Rana Dhankar, a young 23-year-old Greco-Roman wrestler living in a flat owned by Sushil.
Sagar, chalo mere saath, kuch baat karni hai.
Sagar was with his four roommates at the time, including his gangster friend Sonu Mahal.
Jo baat karni hai yahan kar, hum kahin nahi jayenge.
When Sagar refused, kahan leke ja rahe ho mujhe? The location they took him to was well known to all wrestlers in India, Chhatarsal Stadium, New Delhi, where a reception was pre-planned for them in the parking lot.
Oye Prince, chal recording shuru kar.
And proceeded to beat the four of them mercilessly.
Mere baare mein bahut bakwas kar raha tha na, ab kahan gaya tera dam?
At one time, Sushil and Sagar were thick friends. But they fought over the spoils of a real estate deal, as Sushil felt that Sagar was becoming increasingly independent and demanding. So this was his way of keeping him and others with similar intentions in check.
Ye sabko warning hai, apni apni aukaat mein raho, nahi to yahi haal hoga.
Hearing police sirens, they hurriedly left, leaving the four victims bleeding in the parking lot. The next day, Sushil was woken up by the constant ringing of his phone. The call was from a journalist working for ANI.
पहलवान जी, हमने सुना है कि कल स्टेडियम में कोई झगड़ा हुआ और उसमें एक की मौत भी हुई.
Sushil gave him an evasive reply.
हमारा कोई लेना देना नहीं उसमें. किया होगा कोई और झगड़ा, पता है पुलिस को?
But Delhi police had already named him first accused in a FIR and issued a non-bailable warrant with a reward of 1 lakh. Fearing arrest, Sushil and Ajay had already left Delhi, taking refuge at an ashram in Haridwar before moving to Rishikesh. As raids began to intensify, they left for Mathura by car, where their images were captured by CCTV cameras at a toll booth. Always on the move, in the next few days, he kept shuffling between Delhi and Bahadurgarh, but later fled to Chandigarh. For the first 3 days, he did use his mobile phone intermittently, but later destroyed it, contacting his associates via Telegram using an internet dongle on his SIM-less phone to avoid being tracked. But thanks to HUMIT, human intelligence, developed by the Delhi police over the years, they soon got an important tip.
Pehlwan ji is going to come back to Gurgaon to collect cash from a liquor supplier.
By evening on that day, at least 3 police units had closed in on him.
Do not let him escape. I repeat, do not let him escape.
Yet he somehow still managed to dodge them, but was unable to collect any money. Realizing that Sushil was short on cash, Delhi's special cell unit laid a trap when one of Sushil's contacts got compromised.
हाँ मैं बोल रहा हूँ, पैसे का कुछ एडजस्ट हो पाएगा?
हाँ भाई जरूर, आप मुझे मुनका मेन मिलो मेट्रो स्टेशन के यहाँ.
As directed, on the morning of May 23rd, World Wrestling Day, Sushil and Ajay, with their faces covered, approached the meeting place on a two-wheeler. But before he could meet his contact, half a dozen police jeeps surrounded and arrested them. Sushil initially claimed he was innocent, but often changed his stories.
Yes, I was at the stadium. I tried to mediate between two groups that were fighting.
But Delhi police had already got their hands on the infamous video clip from Prince Dalal's phone. They also recovered a double-barrel loaded gun with 5 live cartridges and 2 wooden sticks from Prince's car. Vijender Singh, aka Binder, one of the 15 arrested, confessed.
Pehlwan ji asked us to beat up Rana, so we did it.
Finally, during interrogation, Sushil confessed. I only wanted to teach him a lesson so that no one would mess with me in the future. I had no intention of killing him. However, this is not the first time Sushil has landed himself in hot water. In September 2020, he called grocery store owner Satish Goel, who had been supplying rations to the stadium during lockdown.
Payment collect karne ke liye 76 saal aa jao.
Where 30 to 40 wrestlers were ready with पेमेंट।
पेमेंट भूल जाओ।
पहलवान जी 4 लाख कब नहीं, कुछ तो दे दो।
ये ले साले।
In 2016, when Narsingh Yadav beat Sushil to qualify for the Rio Games, Sushil became furious with the Wrestling Federation of India.
I should be going in his place.
Soon thereafter, Yadav failed a dope test, and the needle of suspicion pointed towards Sushil.
He must have spiked my food so that I'll get disqualified from Rio.
A month later, within minutes of completing an ill-tempered bout against Praveen Rana, he and his brother were allegedly assaulted by Sushil's supporters. Right inside Chhatrasal Stadium, the Olympian's fiefdom. A place he took over from his father-in-law Satpal Singh. Over the years, Sushil's ego had ballooned up quite a bit, waiting to burst at the slightest provocation. He pulled out of the 2018 Pro Wrestling League, claiming he wasn't being paid enough. His love for weapons even shocked a fellow Olympian when during a wrestling meet organized by Northern Railways.
See my gun, it's a beauty fully loaded.
In 2015, he forced Tokyo bronze medalist Bajrang Punia out from Chhatrasal Akhada, depriving him of training with the best wrestlers. Now, he had an axe to grind with Sagar, and an alleged fight that broke out at Sonu Mahal's party celebrating his Ukrainian girlfriend's birthday was the turning point. It is said that Sushil's friend Ajay Bakkarwala approached the birthday girl in a highly drunken state.
Let me take a selfie with you.
भाई तूने ज्यादा पी ली, नीचे बैठ जा।
मुझे मत सिखा क्या करना है,
ठीक से बात कर, जो उखाड़ना है उखाड़ ले, चल।
Later when Ajay and Sushil were sitting together,
ये सोनू और सागर को जल्दी सबक सिखाना होगा।
Both Sonu and Sagar had already been on Sushil's radar when they had earlier thrashed a wrestling coach close to him. Something was going to happen, and unfortunately, Sonu paid with his life. Sushil Kumar's arrest has revealed the dark underbelly of the wrestling world. Retiring wrestlers, after years of competing at lower levels, now in their mid-30s and with no other job skills, work as muscles for hire. One area where their muscle is required is in the highly lucrative business of capturing toll booths, where under the cover of night, these wrestlers, using their muscles, guns and cash, would allow trucks and lorries to carry contraband through Haryana toll plazas without checks. It is said that each passage earns them anywhere between 3 to 5 lakhs per vehicle. 3 years back, Sushil is rumored to have joined hands with another gangster, Sandeep Kala, aka Kala Jatheri, and his nephew Sonu Mahal, but fell out with them over an alleged dispute over a property in Model Town. So to strengthen his position, Sushil reportedly got in touch with Jatheri's rivals, who were then lodged in Delhi's maximum security Tihar Jail. Neeraj Bhawana and Naveen Bali, both of whom did not pass up the opportunity.
I need some muscle to deal with Jatheri.
Consider it done, Pehlwanji.
Jatheri, who was then rumored to be in Dubai, vowed revenge. On hearing of this threat, Sushil in turn bolstered his gang by hiring more wrestlers. The night Sagar was murdered, police suspect Sushil actually wanted to hurt Sonu Mahal, Jatheri's nephew and Sagar's roommate. Because among the people who beat up Sagar were 7 members of Bhawana's gang. But after the gang was arrested, Sushil got cold feet as he was now left all alone to face Jatheri's wrath. So while on the run, he desperately tried contacting Jatheri to try and settle the matter. But before that could happen, the police arrested Sushil. Some even suspect that Sushil got himself arrested purposely as he felt safer in custody than being available to Jatheri as a target. While on one hand, wrestlers like Bajrang Punia, who once trained at the very same Chhatrasal Stadium, are making India proud in Tokyo, Sushil Kumar, himself a 2-time Olympic medalist, bronze in the 2008 Beijing Olympics and silver in 2012 London, has done the opposite and tarnished his sports image. There was a time when wrestlers from North India touched Sushil's feet when they came to Chhatrasal Stadium.
Aap mere guru hain, give me your blessings.
Even Sagar considered him as one, as his father remembers.
Sagar had been at Chhatrasal for nearly 8 years. He also looked up to Sushil as his guru.
What a fall from grace for this idol. A lesson of how easy money can turn even the good to bad. Unfortunately, Sushil Kumar is not alone in the list of sportsmen turned criminals, almost all of whom played contact sports. Sadly, instead of Sushil being in the history books as a two-time Olympic medalist, he will now be remembered as a history cheater. Bisbo's limerick. A medalist for India in two Olympic Games, Sushil Kumar now lives in ignominious fame. All too soon, he turned into a goon. Now the rest of his life will be filled with shame. Subscribe to Bisbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bisbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.